Hello everyone, and today we're going to see how to make amazing animated videos using Animaker. And for that, we're going to see how to make an awesome video like this one right here. That looked awesome, didn't it? So how exactly do you make a video like this? Well, let's go take a look. So welcome to the Animaker application. So as we can see, it's just divided into five simple parts, and the main ones right here is the workspace where you're going to be doing all your awesome creation. To the right are the scenes which you will be using to make your amazing video. In the bottom, we have the timeline where you can control when your character comes in, when different effects come in, when they go out, and all of that right here. And to the left is a massive library where you can go ahead and find characters, objects, everything to make your video just seem that much more better. So let's start creating our awesome video. And first up, let's give this a nice background. So to do that, just click anywhere on your workspace. And you can see that you get this option right here. And if you just click on this little pencil button here, you'll be able to give any color that you want. And if you just click on this option, you'll be able to go ahead and adjust it to the exact color that you want it to. Now let's go ahead and bring out a character. So if we go and click on any characters over here, you can see that they appear directly onto the workspace. Perfect. And once the characters come in, you'll notice that this little purple bar comes onto the timeline. So this is how long a character is going to stay on your timeline. And you can see that, let's just call her Jane. And Jane is going to be staying on the timeline from the first second all the way till the 10 second. Now, if I don't want a scene to be this long, like say 10 seconds, all I have to do is go ahead and click on this little minus button. And if I want to make the scene a little bit longer, I just have to go and click on this little plus button right here. So I'm just going to reduce this to say 5 seconds. There we go. So let's make this video about promoting a little cafe right around the corner. And we're going to go ahead and start out by asking a question to all of our audience. And if you just click on this little T button right here, you will get a bunch of different text options. All of these are nicely animated. And if you want to go ahead and create your own text, you just have to click on it right here. So I'm just going to click on this. All right. So let's go ahead and customize our character and our text right now. So let's start off with the text. Let's just click on this. And you can see that a settings menu appears on the right hand side. And in this settings menu, you can do a huge bunch of different stuff like change the font, change the size, color, and a bunch of other stuff as well. So I'm going to go ahead and quickly change the color right here. Click on this palette. Let's make any color that we want. I would like this to be white. And I'm just going to go ahead and select all of this. And I'm going to type in my own text. Are you feeling hungry? There we go. Now, the thing is, Jane doesn't exactly seem to be questioning it, or she doesn't seem to think that this is a question. So we're going to go and change the way that she looks right now. And with that, I mean, we're going to give her a nice little action and an expression. So with the actions over here, you can see that for the characters, this entire window shows a bunch of different actions that our characters can do. And I'm just going to go click on this where she is looking at us very happily, but with her arms crossed. So it doesn't look like she has a question. And if I just go ahead and click on this tab right here, you can change the expressions as well. So I'm just going to go and click on this sad expression, and you can see that Jane is now sad, and of course she's feeling hungry. And there we go, we have one scene ready. Now let's add another scene. So it's as simple as just clicking on this little plus button, and now we're going to bring out a nice little background. And let's just say I want to get a nice city. So there are a bunch of different backgrounds that we do have, and you can choose whichever one you want, but I personally like this little city over here. And I'm going to go ahead and add my own text this time, so I'm not going to use a pre-built. And you can see that they also appear right in the center, and I'm just going to say head downtown. And now I need Jane to actually head downtown. So how do we make her do that? So let's bring Jane back onto the screen, and let's find a nice little action where she's actually either driving a vehicle. Okay, so this looks good. So she's driving a little scooter. We're going to place her right here, and we're going to animate her so that she moves all the way to the other end of the screen. And we're going to do that very easily by just using this little option right here. Simply click on it, and you can see there are a bunch of different smart movement options that are ready made for you, from feathers falling to snowflakes to even floating in the water. So the little left to right option is perfect, and we're just going to use that. So I'm going to drag her all the way across the city like this. I'm just going to click on apply, and once that's done, you can see that two little pins appear here. I'm just going to make sure she just goes quickly across like this, and if we go ahead and just adjust how long the scene is and we play it, you can see that Jane just zooms across the entire city. That's perfect. If you want to make the animation slower, you just drag these two little pins apart further from each other, and it'll make it slower. But if you drag them closer together, it'll just speed up your animation as well. And I'm just going to quickly show you this once again. There we go. Now she's cruising nice and easy down the road. Let's add a third scene. So this is where we bring out the bistro. And let's search for a nice little cafe. This looks good, and the sign over here looks a little bit empty, so we're going to give it a nice little look to it. So I'm going to go and search for a property, and I'm just going to type, say, coffee. There we go. Just going to go and place this right over here. And you can see that you can change a bunch of different colors that are available by just clicking on this right here. I can change the color of the coffee cup to whatever I would want. And you can customize any of the properties and characters to fit exactly how you want it to. But now I need to bring Jane all the way to the center of the screen right here and go inside this restaurant. So how am I going to go and do that? Well, we're going to use an amazing tool called Action Plus. For that, I'm going to click on Jane right here. I am going to go ahead and find an action where she is walking. Nope, that's skipping along. There we go. I'm just going to go and click on this little button right here, which will flip her over. And then gently place her here. And now we're going to go and use Action Plus. And to use Action Plus, you simply come over here, click on this little button right here, and it'll turn on Action Plus. So Action Plus will help us add a sequence of actions to a character so that they can do it easily one after the other. So I want Jane to walk all the way in here and give us a nice little wave. So we're going to do that by simply clicking on the plus button right here. And let's go ahead and find an action where Jane is waving at us, like this one right here. Now I'm just going to go and simply place this here. Click on this little tick mark. Click on apply. And just like last time, I'm just going to go ahead and drag these pins apart. Now if I just click on apply and then play the scene, you can see that Jane just walks in. She stands there and just waves at us. Perfect. All right then. So let's just go and create a welcome sort of scene to everyone for the restaurant. So I'm just going to go ahead and name the restaurant right now. Let's just click on under of our text variables. And like I mentioned before, there are a bunch of different options over here so that you can go ahead and customize it exactly the way you want. And let's just say head over to I'm going to go ahead and name the restaurant Santa's Bistro. Let's just place this right in the center like this. Awesome. And there we go. Finally, Jane is going to be super happy once she gets into the restaurant. So let's just go ahead and show a nice little background showing the inside of the restaurant. So this looks nice and cozy. And let's go ahead and bring out a table which shows the inside. There we go. I'm just going to place this right here. Just like before, we can go ahead and change the color of this. And for this restaurant, I want the people who come in to kind of like try out the specials. And so I'm just going to say try out our special menu. We can go ahead and just reduce the size of this text a little bit. And it will fit all in one spot. There we go. Let's make this nice and small, and we can just center that as well. Finally, we're going to go ahead and bring out Jane as again into the scene. And since she's arrived here, I want her to be super happy and excited. Like this right here. And the thing is, I don't just want her to be looking happy, I want her to sound happy as well. And for that, we're going to go and add a voiceover to Jane right now. To add a voiceover, simply click on this little button right here. And you will get three options. You can record your voiceover inside the application right here. You can use our text-to-speech software. Or of course, you can upload your own file if you have it, and it will automatically sync with the character. So I have a little shriek of joy that I want Jane to show, and I'm going to upload it right here. And there we go. Now if I play this scene, and let's just play the scene right here. You can see that Jane just jumps up and down with joy, and she also sounds super happy. So that is a nice and easy way to make your characters show more than just facial expressions. They can also show themselves being very happy, and it just takes a few clicks. Let's end this by welcoming everyone to our restaurant. And we're just going to go ahead and give this a nice white color right here, and we're going to bring out a logo, which is, since it's called Santa's Bistro, I'm just going to get out a Santa Claus. There we go. Let's just place them here. And you can see that some of our properties have this little animation toggle. And if you just click on this, you can see that the Santa Claus is doing his own little cute little shuffle. So you just have to toggle this on and he is going to be shuffling cutely over there for the rest of the video. Alright, and finally, we're just going to add one last bit of text. And there we go. Let's just change this to Santa's Bistro. And I'm just going to give this a nice hashtag. And if you want to go ahead and add like a little transition between the last two slides, you just click on this little option right here. I'm just going to use this. Again, simply just click. And our video is almost ready. We just need to go ahead and add a music track. So to add a music track, all you need to do is click on this little part of the timeline, which is the video and audio timeline. You go to our music section, which has a ton of amazing music tracks for you to select from. And I'm just going to go ahead and see if there is a nice little track which I want for this video. So if you want to preview any of our tracks, just hover over them and you'll be able to see what exactly they sound like. Okay, so that sounded peppy. I really do like that. I'm just going to click on this little plus button and it's added. Once it's on the timeline, you can go and change a bunch of different settings like its volume. You can duplicate it and a bunch of different stuff there as well. So now that everything is ready, let's just see how our video looks like. There we go. Our awesome video is ready in just a few clicks and it's just that simple to do. So once you're done with your video, all that's left is to publish it. And you can easily do that by just coming over here and clicking on this button right here. You can download it directly into your computer or directly publish it to any of the social media all listed here. And finally, if you want to, you can also share it with any teammates or people that you'd like to work along with so that they can also help by creating their video. And that is how you guys can make amazing animated videos using Animaker. So, did we miss anything out? If you guys have your own tips or you'd like to know anything more about it, please leave that in the comments below and we'll be happy to take a look at it.